In this tutorial, I'll show you how to animate particles along a path. Begin by creating a composition, then go up to Layer, New, Solid, click OK, then open Effects and Presets and search for Particle Systems, then add this effect to the solid layer. Then in Effect Controls, let's expand Producer, Physics, and Particle to see all of the settings, then move the time indicator forward to see the particles, and now let's adjust the look of the particles. You don't have to follow my exact steps, I'm just showing you how to create the particles that you saw in the intro. So we set the birth rate to 25, longevity to 3, radius x and y to 0, animation to 12, velocity 0.05, inherent velocity negative 5, gravity 0, resistance 1, then particle type faded sphere, birth size 0.05, death size 0, size variation 100, max opacity 100, and for color, I'm going for white, both for birth and death colors. So here we've created the particles, now let's create a path that the particles will follow. And there are multiple ways you can do that, and I'll show you two very different approaches. But first, let's go up to Layer, New, Null object. Now select the null, then hold Ctrl on the keyboard and double click on the pan behind tool to center the anchor point, then open the align tab and align the null object horizontally and vertically to put it to the center of the composition. Now for the first approach, we're going to go up to Window and enable Motion Sketch. Now select the null one, and inside of the motion sketch, let's click on Start Capture button. Now we need to click and hold the left mouse button and draw a path that we would like the particles to follow. And as we do that, our movement is being captured in real time, and in the end, we will get the position keyframes. If we expand null one, then go into Transform, you can see that the position is animated and we have a lot of keyframes. Now to adjust the speed of the animation, we need to click on Position to select all the keyframes, then right click on any of the keyframes, select Rove Across Time. Now we need to deselect the keyframes and move the very end keyframe either forward or backward in time. And for the second approach, instead of really drawing a path, we're going to use the Pen tool. So first let's select the null one, then select the Pen tool and create a path that you would like the particles to follow. And this will create a mask. If we expand masks, then go into mask 1, then select the mask path by clicking on it, then press Ctrl C to copy the mask path, then move the time indicator to the start of the timeline, then under transform, we need the position, click on it, and press Ctrl V to paste the mask path into the position. And you can see that also adds keyframes, and we don't need to right click and do anything since it's already checked, so we just click away and move the end keyframe either forward or backward in time. And at that point, we can select the mask and delete it since we no longer need it. So regardless of which approach you go for, once you have the path ready and you have the position keyframes, you want to expand the settings to see the position down here. Then you expand the settings of the solid, go to Effects, Particle System, then Producer, and I'm going to move this up to give ourselves some space. And now we need to click and drag this pick whip that's next to Producer's position and drag it onto the position of the null object and let go. And that will make the producer of the particles follow the path that we created, and you can see everything is working fine. And at this point, we can add a glow to the particles. If you have Deep Glow plugin available, feel free to use it. If not, then we can always use the regular glow. So search for it in Effects and Presets and add the glow to the solid layer. Now I'm going to increase the glow radius to 200, then select the glow, press Ctrl D to duplicate it, and increase the radius of the glow to 600. And now we have glow applied to the particles. And if you want to change the color of the particles, you can always go back to the particle settings under the particle systems and adjust both birth and death colors to any other color you want. And that's pretty much it for this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching.